Now to the Southern California firefighter who was put in handcuffs by police while trying to help victims of a car crash. The bizarre incident captured on camera. And ABC's Ryan Owens has the story.
Okay, I don't have time for a cell phone. This is ridiculous.
A firefighter in the back of a police cruiser. How'd he end up in handcuffs? He says he was just doing his job, stopping to rescue two people in a flipped car on a California interstate. His firefighting colleagues cannot believe it.
We're in the middle of patient care with patients on the freeway, and we're trying to protect our scene, and they're putting him in handcuffs at this time and walking him away.
12-year veteran Jacob Gregor parked his fire truck so it blocked traffic on Interstate 805 near San Diego, making sure no cars came close to the flipped one or to the ambulance the driver and passenger were being loaded into. As their radio traffic makes clear, the California Highway Patrol wanted him to move his truck.
Everything is speedy and fire's locking up for no reason here. One and too late. We're trying to get him to move right now.
The firefighter refused and spent a half hour in the back of that police cruiser when he says he should have been helping the injured. Gregor was never actually arrested and was released, but his boss, the fire chief, remains outraged.
My engineer followed protocol and did exactly what he was supposed to do.
The fire chief met with the head of the highway patrol, and the two released this statement, making nice with each other. Both of our agencies have the utmost respect for each other and our respective missions. This was an isolated incident. An incident some believe has caused a rift between the rescuers we all depend on in an emergency. For Good Morning America, Ryan Owens, ABC News, Los Angeles.